I think it's a very exciting time for animation. There's, I guess, a few trends that provide, as always, challenges and opportunities. And I think we're in the middle of both a globalization process, so the globalization of animation production, where through communications and through access to animation creation tools, many people in many different parts of the world can start to create movies, work with people in other parts of the world to create movies or TV shows. And so it's a very fertile creative environment. Now a student or someone in their home can start working on things, communicate with other people. Small countries can make animation. So for my country, where I live, I think people, I mean, it's still very, very much dominated by the handful of very large players, the big studios and the big TV channels. But you start to see with the general public an awareness of other types of animation in the world that's not just Disney, Pixar, or Saturday morning cartoons. You have, the films of Studio Ghibli and Hayao Miyazaki and some of the films from Europe starting to break through, and people are saying, oh, animation is not just for kids. Animation is not just these big toy-driven vehicles. You know, we're a distributor of independent feature animation, and we've had, I think, a very good track record of introducing a type of film into the United States that would not otherwise have gotten distributed, and having quite a measure of success, albeit on a independent scale, not on a massive scale. And so our first feature film was The Secret of Kells from Cartoon Saloon in Ireland, which was also a co-production of Les Amateurs here in France, with Didier Brunet, whose party I went to last night. And that was our first Oscar nomination. It really raised the profile of Cartoon Saloon. It raised the profile of European animation. And we've since had 10 Oscar nominations for our feature films, from films, from Ireland, from France, from Japan, from Brazil, from countries all over the world. So that's been very, very positive. I think one of our core competencies is being flexible and adaptable and seizing opportunities wherever they are. And I'm really mostly driven by working with people that I like and working on projects that I like and not thinking too much about how the business is going to work. And that's been a very positive tool for us. There are significant challenges. The cost of acquiring films for us has gone up. As we've had some success with these films, other people have come in. You've got these big players, as I mentioned, like Netflix and Amazon. On the one hand, they're a very big part of our success in our P&L. When we have that eventual sale for our films, it's a good payday for us and for the filmmakers. On the other hand, they're buying direct. I'm really, to be honest, not worried so far. We've done a good job at that. You know, in terms of what we're doing, other than continuing to do what we do and do it well, we are getting into production. The Breadwinner, which is an Oscar nominee for us last year, and which is here at Annecy, was our first sort of official production. So it's interesting that a lot of people are still measuring success solely on box office or on admissions. When you talk to a French person, how many admissions did you have? How many admissions? And sometimes that's a good gauge of success, but it's not always a good gauge of financial success for film, and it's not always a good gauge of ultimate success for a film. The theatrical market in the United States, success is measured in 200 million or more at the box office. No French films or European films have done that. And in order to do that, they would have to become a type of film that maybe I'm not that interested in, because other people are doing that very, very, very well. Disney, Universal, these companies. The scale of theatrical release is one thing, and then there's the scale of acceptance in the home video market. There's how did it do in the awards campaigns. What is the profile of the filmmaker? How easy is it to make his next film? And then ultimately, are you able to get a good sale to Netflix or Amazon or Hulu or one of these others, and people can see your film there. But we're doing many things here. We had our big 10th anniversary party last night, which was really fun, and got to see a lot of old faces and filmmakers we worked with many years ago, and drink a lot of tequila. We are here meetings and meetings and meetings. I have 10 meetings a day. We have 4 people here. We're looking at new projects. We're looking, talking about distribution ideas, meeting with people from not just from Europe, but from Japan and South America and China. And we're also partners with Annecy, as I mentioned, on Animation as Film. So we sit and we talk to them about ideas for what we're doing out in the our big Los Angeles Film Festival. You know, what are we planning? So for us, this is a big celebration every year to come here for a week and be in the sun or be in the rain and stay up all night and get up early and eat a lot of cheese.